If you're anything like me, volleyball was a sport that probably wasn't at the top of your list of your favorites when you were a kid. You were probably always aware of it, but you couldn't name any professional players, and your limited time playing volleyball was on a beach or grass with a shoddy net on a family vacation or a school summer camp. It's a sport with a long tenured history and has grown so much in international recognition that it's now considered one of the big five international sports. And its main governing body, the FIVB, is the largest international sporting federation in the world. It's seen astronomical growth in the past two decades and has generated tons of sporting interest in the Olympics starting in 1964, the Volleyball Nations League, the World Cup, the World Championships, and tons more individual leagues. It's also been the subject of tons of popular culture, including its most famous iteration in haikyuu. So how did the sport, which didn't even have Olympic representation 60 years ago, become one of the biggest sports in the world with 900 million players? To know that, we have to go back to the beginning. Volleyball was a sport born out of limitations. In fact, it was not even initially called volleyball. Its first name was Mintonet. Mintonet was first created by a man named William G. Morgan in 1895, who at the time was searching for a ball sport for his job as the Director of Physical Education at the Holyoke, Massachusetts YMCA. Morgan wanted a ball sport which was suitable for both the young and the old, since basketball was considered too violent to be suitable for the older generation to play. In his first experiments for a new sport, Morgan is quoted as saying, "In search of an appropriate game, tennis occurred to me, but this required rackets, balls, a net, and other equipment, so it was eliminated. But the idea of a net seemed a good one." Eventually, he commissioned a company known as A.G. Spaulding & Brothers for a new ball to play his sport. The ball was leather-covered, with a rubber inner tube. Eventually, a local demonstration of Mintonet at a university led to a proposition by one of the spectators, Professor Alfred T. Halstead. It was eventually decided that Mintonet would change its name to volleyball. Originally, Mintonet was played with three servers and nine innings to 21 points as a baseball replicant, with no rules regarding back row violations or maximum hits per side. In 1917, this was changed to three sets of 15 points, and a 3-meter line and hit limit was introduced as a rule in 1920. A revolution to the sport of volleyball occurred in 1916 in the Philippines, where a new offensive style was created in which the ball was passed at a high trajectory to another player who would jump up and hit the ball downward. These new techniques were named the spike and set movements. A variation of volleyball played on outdoor areas was first introduced in 1930, with its first officialization in 1948, occurring at a small American tournament played at Will Rogers State Beach in Santa Monica, California. This was the first officially recognized beach volleyball competition in the United States. The following year, the first ever Volleyball World Championships took place in Prague, Czechoslovakia, which was won by the Soviet Union, who only dropped two sets in five matches to win the title. It didn't take long for volleyball's popularity to explode worldwide. Because of its ease of access and lack of equipment needed, it quickly became a popular sport in all corners of the world. By 1964, volleyball had its first feature at the Olympic Games, in where else but Tokyo. Again, the Soviets dominated, dropping only five sets in nine games with a final record of eight wins and one loss, the only loss coming by the way of the host, Japan. Here is what the final standings of the first Olympic volleyball competition looked like. As of 2021, there are four international volleyball tournaments currently in circulation. Three of these are FIVB-sanctioned tournaments, being the FIVB World Cup, the World Championships, and the Volleyball Nations League. The fourth, of course, is the Olympic competition. As far back as 1949 and 1964, Eastern Europe's dominance of the sport was pretty well established. It wasn't until the 1984 Olympic Games in Los Angeles did the United States first achieve a medal in men's indoor volleyball.
Serve for the United States. The silver. Tabarrik. Carrasco.
From which they carried on their strength with multiple medals in 1988, 92, 2008, and 2016. In recent years, Brazil has been an absolute powerhouse nation, with three golds and two silvers since 1992. Brazil has also won 3 of the last 5 Volleyball World Cups and 3 of the last 5 World Championships. The women's leagues, however, are a completely different story. Much in the same way that women's Olympic sports are less dominated by the Americans as the men's, so too is volleyball. In fact, the United States women's volleyball team has never won a gold medal, ever.
Whoa! It's out! And the Boskovic has won it for Serbia!
In the early stages of Olympic volleyball, the games were completely dominated by Japan and the Soviet Union. Between 1964 and 1980, there was only one instance where a team other than Japan or the USSR even made it to the gold medal match, and that was East Germany, who won silver in Moscow in 1980. Interestingly, Italy has never even placed in the top 4 in women's Olympic volleyball standings, but has won 2 World Cups in 2007 and 2011. The game of volleyball that we all love to watch and play today is similar to how the game is played 25 years ago, but not exactly the same. Here are some interesting rule changes that have occurred in the last 25 years. It wasn't until 1997 that players were able to go to the other side of the net to retrieve an errant pass. The whole libero position wasn't even invented until 1998, and wasn't officially played until the 2000 Sydney Olympics.
I think Eric was teaching us that stuff before. He gets a fantastic job. There it is.
Also in 1998 was the introduction of the 25-point set rule, where it was also established that points were given based on whoever won the point. This might sound a bit strange, but before that, points were only added to your team's total if you were the serving team. Imagine how long 5-set matches could have gone on for if you could still only win points on your team's services.
There's been a ton of other interesting rule changes that have occurred in the last 25 years, but I'll cover those in another video. Volleyball has had an illustrious history from the very start, and its growth has only been exponential. Recently, there's been over 900 million active players and fans, including 40 million in just the United States alone. And a big part of that growth is due to, which has been a massive influence in bringing new fans into the sport. If you don't believe me, go check out any Yuji Nishida volleyball highlight video and look at the comments. See how many Haikyuu fans there are around the world. This channel takes a huge influence from volleyball and from Haikyuu as well, so if you love either of those things, consider subscribing. And if you want to see more content just like this, make sure to leave a comment and tell me what kind of topics I should cover next. This has been Blockchain. Thanks for watching, everyone.